welcome back to the Final Five. We all know him from his award-winning role as Kurt Hummel on the hit show Glee. Now Chris Colfer is taking on the big screen, writing, producing, and starring in a quirky dark comedy about high school. Take a look.
You have beaten me down to the bottom of the high school food chain with the end of the stick for far too long. You don't think they're going to believe me? I will make them believe me. You don't think they've just been waiting for an excuse to turn against you? I mean, sure, they all hate me, but that's because I'm the only person in town with an IQ larger than my shoe size, and I don't hesitate to remind people that. So go ahead, sweetheart, and play all the mind games that you want to with me, okay? I'm not accepting that invitation to intimidation any longer, all right? I've got a whole hell of a lot to gain and nothing to lose, and this time, none of you are stopping me.
I'm doing well.
Fancy this cup is.
Yeah, we're very fancy here. I heard you just got back from France.
I did, yes.
How was that?
Oh, it was amazing.
Yeah?
Amazing, yeah. It was one of the first vacations I've been able to take in like 3 years, so it was really nice.
Had you been there before? Or?
Yes, but I never really got a chance to enjoy the city and you know.
Do you speak French?
I think I do. Yeah. But I know like two words, and I always think I can communicate with the locals, but I can't.
Well, I also find that when I don't speak the language in a place, when I speak English, I do it with like, say if I'm in France, I don't speak French, I speak with a French accent.
Yes, me too.
And I think somehow that I'm like, hello, or like,
yes.
You know, with a weird accent.
No, I think I do that too. Like,
yeah.
like je suis needed towel. Like.
Yeah. You're also, I've seen you on Twitter, you're obsessed with tweeting about your cat.
It's a bit of a problem.
Yeah. And
he has a massive fan base, my cat.
Yeah. It's also National Dress Up Your Pet Day, in case you didn't know.
I heard, yeah.
And you dress up your cat as well.
Occasionally, yeah. Sometimes people bring outfits for him.
Right.
For me, like at my book signings and stuff.
Yeah. There we go.
Mm-hmm.
What does that say?
It says, bitches love me.
That's great.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Yeah. And that's actually for a small dog, but he's too big to fit in cat clothes.
Right. We tried to figure out what to get you, so we got you a gift, which is for both for your cat and you. It's a,
that's great!
It's a beret and an ascot for you, and a matching beret and ascot for your cat.
Oh, my God!
So you can...
amazing!
Yeah.
Do I get to keep the cat?
Sure, you can keep the
great,
cat, too,
great,
if you want.
Yeah. Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah.
That just made my day. Thank you.
You know, you've had a huge impact on so many young people through Glee and through all the stuff you do. That's got to be a great feeling.
It is. It's a really heavy feeling. I feel like sometimes I get way too much credit because, you know, I say things that are written for me and suddenly get a huge a generation that's following me. But it's an amazing feeling, and it's such a... I'm totally spoiled to know what I'm doing is affecting so many people.
And the new film is about high school. What were you like in high school? I mean, did you know you were gay? I mean, you knew you were gay in high school.
Yeah, I knew. I was aware. But very different. I was very eccentric and very frustrated that no one got my why I was eccentric and why I was so passionate about things.
Mm-hmm. And do you miss high school?
I miss the lunch ladies.
They were
my girls. I miss them, and I miss teachers, but I don't miss, you know, being in the trenches every day, which
right.
I call the hallways.
Same. Also in the film, Rebel Wilson is in the movie. I'm obsessed with her.
Oh, good.
Is she as funny in real life as she is in the film?
She's amazing. Probably more amazing than you think. Yeah, she's hysterical. And like, I say half of her lines in this movie are ad-libbed. And I don't know how I was able to hold a straight face.
Have you also always written? Because, I mean, you wrote this. You've written another book.
Yeah. Ever since I was little, it all kind of... I got bit by the acting bug and the performing bug and the writing bug all at the same time. Because, like, as a kid, it was all just pretend. It was all make-believe. And so I've been doing it for as long as I can remember.
Yeah. Well, I'm so happy for all your success. I really
wish you
the best. Yeah.
Thanks.
And everybody in the audience is going to go home with a copy of Chris's book, which is based on the new movie, Struck by Lightning. It's in select theaters, also on demand, and on iTunes right now. Check it out. We'll be right back.